A ticket to the Final Four is up for grabs in tonight's Elite Eight matchup between the Wisconsin Badgers and the Duke Blue Devils.
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Blue Devils are facing a very formidable opponent, Dick. What are the keys to their success?
Hey, tonight the keys to their success are these, Brad. First of all, get the ball on the interior. See if you can get that big man into foul trouble. Second of all, make good passes and force the other team to play honest defense. And finally, win the battle on the glass. That's going to be huge tonight. Boy, that stat at the end could be a big one.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us.
I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Second one is no good. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Puts up the shot. The shot's off target. Both teams are looking to get something going here. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension. I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up-and-under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up-and-under move to utilize good footwork.
Looking for a good shot. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Number 21 takes the feed. And they don't score there either. Number 45 with the ball. He looks at the hoop. Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. And he'll kick it back outside. They look to get it to the inside. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression. Trying to go inside.
For two. Doesn't go. Dumps it in. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Hey, the crowd loved that one, Brad. But did you see the mascot? He's so excited. I think he may pull something up there jumping around like that. He's going to get hurt. Hey, don't hurt yourself, big fella. They need you to cheer. There's the trap.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Dickey's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
Number 32 takes the pass.
I'd say a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Went away from the post and goes the other way. Number one picks up the foul. First personal foul. a man in high post. The small forward gets the ball. He nails the bucket. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Trying to feed inside. And he'll kick it back outside from the top of the circle.
He got off the nice shot off the dribble by running the defender into that solid screen.
Number 32 is eager and excited to compete.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
The ball goes out of play. Gave it up. The fake. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. And they get the turnover. It's just great hustle and great defense of the steal.
I'll tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player. Great anticipation defensively.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Wisconsin have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
The power forward gets the pass. He strokes it off the rim and no good.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Takes the pass in the paint. Fake. He goes with a jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Turnaround jumper. They still don't score. In the paint. Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
A good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Takes the pass in the paint.
He missed the easy bucket inside off the screen.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Step out on that screener.
Tries for two, and he scores it off the glass. Shoots from right of the circle, way off target.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
And working around the perimeter. Here's a double team.
Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
And a momentary look from three-point land.
There's the screen up on top.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
Free throw is good. And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. Controlling the ball. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
Thanks, Erin. Now the high screen for two. Wisconsin are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they've started to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He shoots from the top of the key. Can't put it down. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
He lets it go. Off the rim and no good. Looking for a good shot. There's the pick.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. He tries to knock down the three.
He missed the jumper off the nice screen.
Perfectly executed. Fakes it. For the bucket.
I tell you, terrific shot. Really impossible to get a piece of that baby.
Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
On the outside.
The frustration right there.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Wisconsin have gotten themselves into a bit of a rhythm on offense, Dick. They're really on a nice run right here.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Inside.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect for saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
On the dribble, gives it up.
That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
way outside. Way off target. Goes up for two. And he missed. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
The turn, a fadeaway jumper.
I tell you, uses the ball really well, too, in terms of putting it to the deck, turns, spins. He's got every move in the book.
They work the perimeter. Entry pass in the paint.
Great play to take that to the basket.
He fakes the shot. He goes with a baby hook. In and out. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
Looking for the foul.
Brad, if they were smart, they'd go 2-for-1. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I'll tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. With a little baby hook. They still don't score. Shot clock is dead. And he'll kick it back outside from three-point range. Great shot. Looking for a good shot.
Look at that spacing.
For the bucket, and in and out. He puts it up there. And the ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
At the half, the Badgers lead by 11. Let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. Number three had what some might call an ordinary first half, partner.
You know, Brad, I think he's sacrificing individual stats for the greater good of the team. Though it doesn't appear that being unselfish is working for them at this point, he might want to take a bigger offensive load.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. High post flasher is open. Picked out of the air. Goes up for two.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that.
Picked off. The shooting guard receives the ball. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Good fake. For two. He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if he were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots.
The crowd really admires this young man.
He's very popular, Brad. He has done some great things on the court, and the people really appreciate him for it.
Now they work it around the perimeter on the outside. Push it up on the break. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown.
It's not uncommon to have a few high risers on your team these days. The game has definitely changed in that regard.
The Blue Devils have a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
He shoots from left of the circle. Got it. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Count's getting high. He launches a three. Duke is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Work it around the arc. Outside jumper. The Blue Devils have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding them the ball. It's simple.
Turns it over. Gave it up. And the ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, dude.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team. Look at that great defense right there. Not allowing them to make the turn. Up and inside.
He hammers it home.
Take a look right here. Nobody steps into the driving lane. He allows them to get the crease, the lane, the angle.
In the paint. Tries for two.
I love this guy, Hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
There's a slam. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
Thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you, Aaron's exactly right. Post play is essential if you're going to be effective.
Number 12 is pounded on his way up. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
At the foul line. Nothing but rim. Second shot, good. It away. Nice shot. On the dribble, gives it up. He dials long distance. He buries it. Number 22 is whistled for the foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
The power forward handles the pass. Here's the offensive drop step on a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
He shoots from the angle. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from right of the circle. Rims out.
Look at that spacing.
Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
Ante tried to make the spectacular play, and now he's embarrassed.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
He strips him clean. On the inside, scorches the net.
That's a 9-0 run.
Working it around the perimeter. Takes away the pass. Looking for a good shot. Got the shot if he wants it. Had him in the low block, but opted against it. Jumps in. Basket falls despite the contact. Something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
Steals the pass. Puts up the tray. Off the rim and no good. Jumped in front to take it away. Wisconsin are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they have to keep pushing and seeing if they can force a timeout.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Gave it up. With a tremendous block.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
Like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
The Badgers are beginning to get that additional exposure, especially with all the recent success in the postseason.
Postseason is the time to shine, and they've really excelled of late. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Number 42 is called for the foul. What a play. These kids are fired up now. And if you're going to celebrate, why not celebrate with a teammate?
I'd celebrate too, partner. They are playing some great basketball at the moment.
It's the first. Gets two at the charity stripe.
That's a 15-0 run.
Time to pick up the defense here now. He takes the shot off the baseline. He misses it. Moving it around the perimeter. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it.
Now they work it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two.
Wow, what a super job of running his man into the screen for that sweet jumper.
Shoots from downtown. Off the rim and no good.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. He drains it. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad, as you can imagine, I am seeing a completely different attitude on the bench now than I did in the first half. The coaching staff and players, they just have looks of disbelief on their faces.
All right, thanks, Aaron. For two,
the lay-in.
The Badgers are ahead by 13. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Working it around the perimeter. With a bucket. In and out.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
The power forward handles the feed. For the deuce.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
The ball goes out of bounds. Momentary look from three-point land. There's the rejection. 10 on the shot clock. The ball goes out of play. Nine seconds on the clock. Here they come with a double team to stop it. Wisconsin are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
On the outside. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Picks off the pass. Number 21. Basket and the foul.
Big time opportunity for the senior leader, baby.
Look at him now, just enjoying the moment.
Hey, he's dancing, baby. A dancer. I never knew that. I'm surprised.
Number 21 going to the charity line for the first time tonight. Sinks it. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
There's a double team waiting there. Tries the three. He gets that one to fall. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
The ball.
Applying lots of pressure, Brad, and looking for the steal as well.
The point guard receives the pass. He shoots from right of the circle. He nails the shot. For two, he couldn't get it to fall. Off the lazy pass. And back they come the other way. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
And the ball goes out of play. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important.
He intercepts it.
Nice step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little Borussia Dortmund shorts. Little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. In the paint. Steals the ball. The fans are really satisfied with what's taking place out there on the court. What a reaction.
Hey, that reaction says it all. These fans are ecstatic, Brad. A 5-point lead could go either way with this much time, Brad.
Oh, it certainly can, Dick.
End-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
Aaron's right about that. We're about ready to hit the floor.
Double team now, bad angle.
Comes away with it.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
With the fake. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
The clock again.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
Sometimes a stat that gets lost, Dick, turnovers, and that can kill you in a ball game.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team's performance. If you give teams easy baskets, you got no shot to win.
Number three to the line for the 1-1. Just like in practice. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Second shot is good.
They need points on this possession, baby.
Shot clock is dead. He shoots from the elbow. Nope. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
He misses his second shot. Timeout's called.
Time is not on their side right now, Brad. They need some big shots, baby.
Thank you. start things up again. It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad. The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
Wow, and that stops the clock again.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back to the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
Number 32 goes to the line for the 1-1. Misses the front end of the 1-1. Let's get ready to resume the action. That makes it a two-point game, Dick.
And the palms are starting to sweat, believe me.
He hits it. Change might be in order, don't you think, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if they changed things up a little bit, Brad.
He has to get it off quick. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Duke wins and reaches the end of the road. These are the last road games of the season.
Hey, two wins are all they need, Mr. Nestler. And it's all they're thinking about as this team advances to the magical Final Four.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler.